almost every turn, the Soviet Union made promises about a beautiful future and gave reminders that life in the Soviet Union was better than in the capitalist Western countries. In reality, the standard of living was lower, and people had to deal with housing, food, and other commodity shortages, although newsreels depicted the contrary. Full shelves in the shops. The state put a lot of effort into trying to convince people that their living conditions were better than they were in reality by proposing wishful thinking.
Padomju Savienībā miera un jauncelsmes zemē nepārtraukti aug darba ļaužu labklājība. Jaunais senu pazeminājums vēlreiz apliecina padomju iekārtas nesalīdzināmo pārākumu pār kapitalistisko pasauli. Paldies partijai un valdībai. No visas sirds saka padomju ļaudis.
Soviet ideology stipulated that everyone had to do socially useful work for the state. Opportunities to work privately were very limited, and people who did not work officially were considered sponges and would be publicly shamed and punished in various ways. In contrast, people who worked for the state would receive recognition, bonuses, and various other privileges. In a way, it was like a competition between businesses and the workers themselves.
Brigadiere Nina Leitrāne drīz būs izpildījusi 4 gadu darba normu. Komjauniete Zinaida Volčkova un Tamara Koprālova savstarpēji sacenšoties ikdienas vēl 200%.
Ar vien vairāk cilvēku atbrīvojas no reliģiskajiem aizspriedumiem, atrod ceļu uz īstu pilnvērtīgu dzīvi. No baznīcas publiski atteicies katoļu garīdznieks Boļeslavs Zvejsalnieks.
Soviet ideology claimed all aspects of life could be explained scientifically, and other ideologies were deemed to be flawed. Therefore, Soviet ideology turned against religion and the faithful. Soviet traditions were introduced to replace religious holidays in an attempt to reduce and eradicate the role of religion.
Šo pašu Bībeles maldīgo mācību, kur kādreiz cilvēkiem sludināju, līdz pat savai nāvei atmaskošu līdz pēdējam, lai arī viņi ietu pa gaišo zinātniskā pasaules uzskata ceļu.
In everyday life, you were reminded of Soviet ideology by posters on the walls of houses, by the so-called red corner areas, propagating communism in public institutions, and by targeted newsreels.
Atzīmējot Baltijas 20 gadus, Maskavā atklāja Igaunijas, Lietuvas un Latvijas mākslinieku darbu skati. Mūsu šodienas dzīve, padomju tautas centieni un darbs, atspoguļojas ikvienā eksponātā. Skatītāju atzinīgu novērtējumu ieguva latviešu mākslinieku daļrade. To vidu Eduarda Kalniņa, latviešu zvejnieki Atlantijā, Edvīna Andersona ostā, Edgara Iltnera zemes saimnieki un Oto Skulmes, Ļeņins, latviešu sociāldemokrātu kongresā Briselē.
However, an important role was also given to culture, where ideology was disguised in art forms.